guys. Here, about to take out the fan clutch. I actually just broke it free because the previous owner, as you can see, fucked up that little nut right there. But I did get it free. See right there. I went and rented these tools, right, to take out the fan clutch and everything. These wrenches, they didn't have the size for this car. So if you do go to Advanced Auto Parts, just know that you're gonna have to use either one of those or channel lock. Channel lock worked a lot better because it's thinner, so it fit back there. See, so I can literally take it out now. Yay. Taking this out just like that. Do not let it fall on my condenser. Break something else. Of course. And they went all the way the fuck over there. Alright. Alright, so that's out. Got more space now. Gonna be putting my radiator in now. And then I'm gonna be doing the wiring. Like I said, I'm gonna be doing all of this. And I'm gonna be wiring up the electric fan that I got. I'll be right back. Alright guys, this is the electric fan that I ordered. It comes with the regular brackets that goes through the core of the, through the fins of the radiator. I was going to fabricate my own little brackets and stuff. It's a 16-inch fan, by the way. I ordered the big one instead of two small ones because I knew the big one was going to fit pretty good. So. See, it comes with this. These little zip tie things to go through the radiator. I was gonna make my own brackets, but I don't got time for that right now. I literally went to like four stores to try to get this shit because none of them had them. I don't want to go back out and find some metal. I will get back to that. I will fabricate it at one point. But I'm just gonna go ahead and do this for now. There you go. I'm gonna test fit it on the car. See how it looks. See how much clearance I have. This is gonna go right here. Pretty tight fit, but let me see. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty tight, but should be pretty good. Yep. I'm going to be doing the wiring now, so I'll skip to where I have everything laid out, and I'll let you know, what components you're going to need, and the relays and shit, and what tools you might need. Be right back. Alright, these are the things you're going to need. I mean, that's the wiring diagram that I've made for what I'm going to do right now. You're going to need a relay. You don't know how relays work, basically. When there is power running through 85 to 86, 30 will touch 87. So basically, when there is no power running through these two, when there's no power running through 85 to 86, 87 and 30 will not be touching, so it will not be giving power to whatever you're hooking it up to. 30 is going to be the wire going to the fan. 87 is going to be a hot wire, basically, from the battery. 85 is going to be a hot wire coming through one of the diagnostic ports, which is basically only going to let it turn on while the car is on. And 86 down here, it's not focused, there you go. 86 is going to be the wire. Right there, 86 is going to be the wire going to the temperature switch, which is basically a ground. And then I'm going to be adding a switch on the inside of the car, basically to let me turn it on whenever I want. That's pretty much it. I mean, there's the relay, the fuse that is going to go between 87 and the battery. In case anything goes wrong, the fuse is going to blow, not your fan or anything. This little harness right here, I got it. You don't need it, but I got it to make it easier. It just connects to that, and then this goes, you know, to the things you're going to hook up to. You're going to need a lighter for the heat shrink. You're going to need some connectors, zip ties there and shit. You're going to need different gauge wire. I have 16 and 16 and 14. 14 is going to be for the battery cable and the power cable going to the fan, because you're going to be running that quite a lot, so you want it to be nice thick cable. It's pretty much it for now. I mean, other than that, it's just going to be connecting everything up and putting it in the car. Electrical tape. Make sure you have electrical tape. That's pretty much it. I'm going to set this camera up now, and you guys can see how I take my time and do it all right. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to set up where my relay is going to go, so I know where I have to run the cables and how long they have to be. I think I'm going to put my relay back here, like right there. Usually that's where I see people put it. I mean, I can put it wherever I want, but it's nice to have it right there where you can see it or anything. This is all I've really done right now. I heat shrink that. I didn't use that adapter thing because it was running smaller wire than what I need for this, so I just connected this directly right there. I'm gonna have this right there. I'm gonna connect it right there. It's gonna hang right there. And then this, I'm gonna put there's no fuse in here. I'm gonna put one in here now. And then this is going to go, I have to open this. I gotta open this, but it goes in there. It goes attached in there to get power from this block right here. It gets power from this block, and that's gonna be my battery power right there, because my battery's in the back anyway. I'll be right back when I hook it up, and I'll let you guys see how it looks. Alright, so you can see in there, that's the bolt next to that red cable over there. That's the bolt that I attached the fuse cable too, right there. I put a 20 amp fuse on it. 20 amps should be more than enough. This is water tight right here. Once you close it, there you go. This is going to go right there, but I have it out here for now so that I can put the other wires on it. Second wire I'm gonna do is gonna be basically the one that's 85 right there, which is going to be the accessory on. So basically the fan will only turn on if my car is turned on, basically. And so where I'm getting that from is this little diagnostic port right here. Flip it around. I already took off this little thing, which is a bitch to take out. And I gotta go back to my paper, but I think it was the green and white wire, which you need. I could just open this and see, it's number 16. Can't tell. Yeah, you can't see it in the video, but I don't have one of those little probes to put in there, so I'm just gonna wire it up to the I'm just gonna wire it up down here, and then it'll be sticking out through this right here. So yeah, I'm gonna get on that right now, and when you come back, you'll see two wires on the relay. Be right back. Alright, so what I did was, it was the green and white cable, pin 16. I couldn't get it through this because it was really tight. I didn't want to go get some grease or anything, so I just made a little tiny hole there. I'm going to patch it up with some electrical tape. I'm going to run electrical tape around all of this so that it's not really visible, the red color. So now what I'm going to do is route it. Well, first I'm going to wrap it in electrical tape. I'm going to route it through these wires back here. And then it's going to go into number 85 on the relay. And that's two down, and then two more to go. I'll show you how it looks once I route it around and make it look all neat. And I'll be right back.
I wired this up.
Got little baby zip ties right there. See, I have it wired like that. Zip tie right there. And it's connected to the relay already. Right? It's a little long, but I'll just scrunch it up, and once I tighten everything down, figure it out. I should have used black wire instead of fucking taping this up, because it's just simpler. I'm going to be using black wire for here, but I only have red 14 gauge wire, so I'll be doing that. Right now I'm going to wire the cable that goes to the temperature switch, and I'll let you know how I do that in a few minutes. Alright guys, so what I did was, you can tell, I already added the third one right there, which is 86, added it right there. Have it running through there, these little clips on the side, tied it down there, and it's hooking up right here to the temperature switch. I hooked it up to the black and gray one, which is basically gonna activate it when the auxiliary fan goes on high setting, which is, that's how I want it. So almost done. One more wire, which is gonna be the power to the fan, so I gotta actually mount the fan onto the radiator now. I'll set the camera up so you can see what I'm doing. I'll be right back. We'll be right back. side, so I mounted it with these little ratcheting things that it came with. 2, 3, 4. I used the springs that it comes with. See the springs right there? I'm not sure if I did that right, but it seems to be holding on pretty good. I can actually pick up the radiator by the fan safely. The other side, see, it has a little styrofoam things to not damage it. Looks pretty legit. Gonna test fit it now in the car, see how it goes. All right, so that's the fitment of it. That's the radiator with the fan pretty tight right there. See where the water pump is. It's literally like, I don't know, maybe half an inch away from it. Maybe an inch. No, yeah, like half an inch. I mean, it doesn't shake that much. Just how much it shakes. It should be tighter once I tighten it down back here. Should be pretty good. What I'm gonna do now is take it back out, put the fan shroud on it, see if with the fan shroud everything fits up. Once I put the fan shroud on, basically I'm not taking the radiator back out, so it'll be closer to finishing. Just waiting on the hoses to get here. Supposedly they get here today in the mail, but it is right now 4 o'clock in the afternoon and they haven't dropped off the mail yet. So, and it's a Saturday, so we'll see. All right, so I have the fan shroud on with the tube, the reservoir tube in it already. It's kind of weird how you have to like have it in like that running through there. It's hanging here because I'm waiting for my brother to come out to help me, because I need two people to hold, one to hold the radiator and one to put this in while the radiator goes in at the same time, because there's not enough clearance to slide in the bottom of that fan shroud. So in the meantime, I already saw where the cable is gonna poke out. See right here, basically gonna be at almost at the same angle as this one right here, the temperature switch. So that's what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna wire the power, which is this one down right there, input 30. That's gonna be the one that's gonna go to the fan, the positive of the fan. The negative of the fan, you can literally put it on any solid ground. See, like that right there maybe, but that's gonna be in the way, so I'm probably gonna find a solid ground somewhere else, probably like right here or something, somewhere close. Yeah, because the wire's gonna be right here, so I'll probably put it right there. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna start doing that now. I keep skipping the parts where I'm actually working on the car. It's because I don't have a tripod right now. As soon as I get a tripod, I would most likely be using it with this, which is my phone, or with my GoPro, or my DSLR. But I don't have a tripod right now, so I'll figure something out within the next few videos. You guys can tell me. Once I come out with different videos, you guys can tell me what quality videos you guys like more, which is this one on the phone or the GoPro one. The thing with the GoPro is I don't like that fisheye for videos like this. Once I'm out on the car making videos on the car, drifting and shit, yeah, I like the GoPro a lot better. But for this, I think the phone does it pretty good. Yeah, I'm gonna start doing this now. I'll get back at you when I'm gonna be routing it with this black wire, because it's gonna go to the same spot basically. So I'm gonna be routing it with that one. Too bad it's red. I'll probably twist it up. All right, just got my radiator hoses. Ooh, hello. Hat. Nice little postcard thing. Damn, these are nice, man. They look a little bit darker in person than on this camera, but it looks nice. Little clamps right here. I'll be installing it now. I'm putting in the shroud in the car right now with my brother. But now that I just got this, I can get the car running, hopefully by tonight. All right.